Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride on a one more soft and sleigh. Hey!
Hey, friends, clearly the words didn't reach me, but I know them. Next time better. Well, Tainza, welcome to HYD. Well, I don't know how you are this season. I mean, you can see the trees everywhere. You can hear the jingle bells. Sharon and Aaron, how are you guys doing?
Well, I'm okay, thank you.
I'm good.
I'm just fine. You're just fine.
Yeah.
I understand that you guys are in VAC. Are your plans going as planned or they are not choosing sides?
Well, at first for me it was boring, but anyway, it's the reason we are celebrating this season. It's fun, we get to minister, we get to commune with each other. Yeah.
Amazing, amazing. Aaron, how about you?
My fans are not choosing sides.
They're not choosing sides,
they're just like that.
But regardless, it's a beautiful season.
It's a beautiful season.
Well, I know there are people who are joining us for their very first time. You guys are so welcome to HYD. And we would really love to get to know who you are. We would love to get in touch with you. So please email us, mof.connect@quartetochurch.com, or call that number on your screen.
And if you are wondering what HYD is, yeah, HYD is our teen service right here at Watoto, where we engage with you through the word of God.
That's right.
Encourage you and empower you to become a world changer in your community for Jesus Christ.
Amazing. Speaking of world changers, this holiday there's something great happening, you know. World changers, we are going to transform this world. Eh? We are going to turn it like
we
this.
We are going to turn.
Because MOF Camp is back. Friends, MOF Camp is back. It's been a while without camp, honestly. So Aaron, what are the details of MOF Camp?
So MOF Camp, one, it's going to be at Seroma Christian High School. Mm-hmm. It's going to be from the 3rd to the 9th of January 2023.
Yeah.
And at a small fee of 180K, you and all your friends can be part of this camp.
Yes, and we are challenging you guys to be a part of this, making the world know. Yeah, letting the whole world know. So get your phone, record a video of yourself in case you've been a part of MOF Camp before. Share those highlights on all your stories, on all your statuses, and tag us at Watoto MOF. All the young people around Kampala and the world need to be a part of this. Otherwise, last Sunday we started our sermon series, Great Joy, and we looked at it in detail. I mean, why does this season bring great joy? Sharon, this season, I know everyone is saying great joy, but maybe for you guys it's different. Now, let's be honest. When December started, was it food, gifts, Jesus, or Jesus, food, gifts, or just food and gifts?
Well, you know, for me, I am a gift person. I love gifts a lot. But I mean, the reason for the season is J-E-S-U-S.
Yes.
For me, it was the gifts only.
The gifts only.
At first. But then later, I found out that it's about Jesus.
Aaron, the Secret Santa thing didn't reach me. I hope
the message is still ongoing.
It's still ongoing.
Yeah.
Sharon, we are getting gifts. We are getting gifts.
Yeah, we're getting gifts, y'all.
Friends, let's not forget the reason for this season. Jesus, yeah? So let's go for your 2 cents and we shall get to hear the young people's opinion about something. But before we even ask them, let's first have a small chat here. Have you ever been promised by someone, and that person didn't fulfill their promise?
Yep, I've been promised a lot of times. But guess what? It ended up in betrayal. I felt
it
so bad.
It ended in tears.
Yes.
How about you, Aaron?
Even me, same story. They promise you and they just go. For me, even mine, the person went abroad.
Went with a promise.
They went with it.
Here we are just having tears. Please, in the chat section, I hope it's great joy. Share with us all your opinions. But for now, over to your 2 cents.
Hi.
What's your name?
Samantha.
Has someone ever promised you something and didn't fulfill it?
No, like, happened to everyone. Yeah.
How did it make you feel?
It was heartbreaking. Like, so I got my hopes up and I was all excited and it didn't happen, so it was sad and heartbreaking.
Hey family, what's up? It's your boy Sean back again. Yeah, somebody promised me data. That was actually yesterday but one. But then they never sent data. I actually felt bad because I used the data that was remaining on my phone. So yeah, I felt bad. Really felt bad.
Yes. Someone has promised me something and they didn't fulfill it. And it made me feel bad. I was angry at that person. I felt disappointed and I lost trust in them.
Wow, that was an amazing session of your two cents. But you know what, Sharon? Oh, God. Never breaks his promises. Yeah, just like some people there. But anyway, right about now, let's dive into worship.
Yeah, right now I'm going to be inviting my favorite worship leaders, Tobias and Alfie. Please join me up here as we worship God together.
All right. Thank you so much. And friends, why don't we worship Jesus in a couple of songs together? Come on, everybody, put those hands together like this. Now this is a dance move. Come on, let's sing together.
Oh, come, oh ye faithful, joyful and triumphant.
Oh, come ye, oh, come ye to
together. Let's sing together.
Let's sing choirs of angels singing exaltations.
And sing, all ye citizens of heaven above.
Heaven above, heaven above.
Your blood has my story written. heart loves with no condition. I'm invited into freedom, forgiveness, wider than the snow. There's a living fount I know, with grace and mercy overflow. Love has come to set me free. I've got this joy inside of me, and all my delight, all my delight is found in you. All my delight, and all my delight is found in you. Your joy is a force that can't be broken. Finding in my soul, there's a living fount I know, with grace and mercy overflow. Love has come to set me free. I've got this joy inside of me. See, all my delight, and all my delight is found in you. All my delight, delight is found in you. And find me in the blood, find me in the living water. Death is overcome with freedom, resurrection power. Can you feel it now? This holy rush of love. Can you feel it now? Mercy overflow. Love has come to set me free. I've got this joy inside of me. So there's a living fount I know, with grace and mercy overflow. And love has come to set me free. I've got this joy inside of me. Sing it out, say, for my delight. All my delight is found in you. All my delight, all my delight is found in you. Come on friends, let's give Jesus a mighty shout of praise. Cause our delight is found in Him, and in Him alone. Friends, as we go into our conversation, let me welcome Pascal and Caleb.
Indeed, Jesus gives us so much joy. He is our delight. He is our delight. Thank you so much, Tobias, Sharon, and Alfie. You guys have led us so well. They're actually from our worship academy, right? Who are our very own our children from the Watoto homes. So good to have them lead us in worship. And the whole band as well, by the way. This Christmas season, by the way, you can be a blessing to them. 30,000 shillings to buy them a gift, to put a smile on the face of one little child in one of our villages. You can be a part of that. Visit our website, www.watotochurch.com, to find out how you can get to be a blessing to them. Now, right now we're going to dive into the Word of God, into an amazing conversation. Before we carry on, I want to ask Caleb the question that Priscilla got to ask our friends, and that you got to be a part of as well through your two cents. Caleb, have you ever been made a promise? Someone gave you or made you a promise and never quite came through?
You know, earlier this year around September, somebody told me next week, I'm going to get you an iPhone 14. It had just come out. We're still in the week. We're still in next week. So next week becomes next week. The other week becomes next. What about you, Pascal?
I can't think straight away of anyone that has made a promise to me and not fulfilled it. I can't think of any now. But I want to find out what your experience has been like. If you're watching this live or later on YouTube, go ahead in the chat section, let us know. We would absolutely love to hear from you and what your experience has been like. Last week, we started a brand new sermon series called Great joy. And I was joined by Brian Barungi right here on set. And what we really talked about is, why is it that this season is one that brings us great joy? Why should we be happy that it's Christmas time? And three things stood out really. We ought to rejoice because this season brings us freedom from sin. The coming of Jesus gives us freedom from sin, freedom from the penalty of sin, freedom from the presence of sin, and freedom from the power of sin. Those are the three P's that we talked about last week. Listen, if you missed that sermon, go back to our YouTube video. You can find a whole playlist on YouTube under Watoto Morph or Watoto HYD. You're going to watch that sermon. It was absolutely beautiful. Now, this week, we are carrying on with our sermon series, Great Joy. And today, we'll be talking about the promise fulfilled. And the context here is that the coming of Jesus landed within a context that the coming of Jesus was referred to as the Messiah, the one to come, was actually a promise that was being fulfilled to a people and to individuals. And we're going to be talking about that in a few. Before we carry on, let's just pray together and get into the Word of God. Father, we thank you so much for the gift of your Word. We ask that even as we dive into your Word and start to really just learn principles from it, speak to us and change us in Jesus' name. And everybody says,
amen.
Amen and amen and amen. All right. So now, the very first scripture that I wanted to draw your attention to is found in the book of Luke chapter 2, verses 1 to 20. But that's a big portion of scripture to read. So if you have your notebook, I would like you to pull it out, pull out your Bible. Let's read together that portion of scripture. I'm not going to read the whole of it, but I'm going to read a few verses, really. Verse 10, verse 11, verse 12, that really just lay or speak about the fact that the coming of Jesus was a fulfillment of a promise. Now, right before verses 10, 11, and 12, we know that the children of Israel were living within oppression under the rule, the Roman rule, and they were being oppressed, they were being pushed to the wall, literally, in their earnings, forced to return a lot of money in terms of taxes. Basically, they were being suffocated through that rule. But then they knew through prophecy that a Messiah was going to come and set them free, like I just mentioned earlier. And it was not just done in any way. Every single word about that the coming of Jesus was absolutely right, and it was fulfilled. Yeah. And so we pick that up from verse 10. But the angel said to them, and here the angel is speaking to the shepherd that were really in the vicinity of where Jesus was born, "I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. There will be a sign, this will be a sign to you. We'll find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." And this is exactly what they found. When they moved to that place where Jesus was, they indeed found baby Jesus in a manger. And that was the beginning of the fulfillment of the promise of the freedom of the children of Israel. Like we talked about last week with Brian, they were expecting a Savior that would come and set them free from the oppression that they were going through, like I've just mentioned. But we know that Jesus came to deal with something that was bigger or deeper than what they were actually experiencing at that moment. The coming of Jesus set them free, not only them, but us as well. Absolutely beautiful story.
Absolutely. And yeah, this reminds me of the promises, some of the promises that were said in the Old Testament.
Yes, yes, yes.
One of them was he would be born of a virgin.
Yes.
He would be born in Bethlehem.
Yeah.
And some the one of he would be born in a virgin, you can find it in Isaiah 7, 14. The one you'll be born in Bethlehem, it's Micah 5, 2. You know, all these promises came to
pass.
Came to pass. We got to see them. And I like how one of our own called Peter Stoner, a great mathematician. Now I know there are guys out there like, now he's taking us into math. No, it's just really simple. Yeah. You know, he said that he tried to conduct a probability test on if all the promises that were said about Jesus for a particular person, let's say I as Caleb, it was going to be was going to be quite impossible. And he said that it will be 1 in 10 to to the power 17.
Yeah.
Now, what does this look like? It looks like 0.00000, like 17 zeros there. 17. This is practically impossible.
Impossible for man, yeah.
Yeah, it's impossible for man. Mm. But by the fact that each and every promise, over 300 promises came to pass, this shows that we need, without doubt, to believe that Jesus is our Messiah.
Yeah.
And Jesus is the reason for this season. Yeah. He's the reason that great joy sparks out of us. So,
There's a scripture that I'm just thinking about. I'm going to read it. It's found in the book of Numbers, chapter 29, verse 23, verse 19. This is what it says. God is not a man, so he does not lie. He's not human, so he does not change his mind. Has he ever spoken and failed to act? Has he ever promised and not carried it through? And the answer is absolutely not. He does come through on every single promise that he makes. But now, if I'm really just to recap on everything we've talked about here, the children of Israel that were under captivity, under Roman rule, and going through all these tough times, facing all this oppression, at the back of their minds with the prophecies that they had received, knew that a savior was to come, one that would come and set them free from the trial that they were going through, lead them into the promised land where milk and honey is flowing. They were going through a tough time, but they had that at the back of their minds. And the scripture that I mentioned and I wanted you to read in the book of Luke chapter 2, verse 1 to 20, narrates the account of how Jesus now comes as a fulfillment to the promise that was made. And I like the illustration that you've given, because it proves right that God, only him, can bring about a promise to be fulfilled to the dot. I mean, what are the odds that at a particular time, a certain ruler would call for a census and say, I want everyone to go back in their hometown. And so they had to go back to their hometown and while they're going back, labor pains start and Mary has to give birth. And all those happenings are rightly falling into the cracks so that the promise of God for his people and for individuals come to pass. May I just say this, and this is a scripture that just come to my mind. Everything works out together for our good. For the good of those that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. And so even the decree of the Roman emperor and even them not finding somewhere an accommodation for her to give birth was falling within the plan of God for every single prophecy to be made. But now, all of those are facts and they're in the word of God. What should be our proper response to the fact that we've seen God keep his promise to the children of Israel? One of the ways that we ought to respond to that is by trusting God.
Oh yes.
I mean, what promises has he made to you, to your family, or about your future, about your health? My friend, I want to challenge you today. If he fulfilled it then, he's able to fulfill it now. The Bible says that he was the same yesterday, today, and forever. He is going to come through for you. So one of the proper responses is to trust in him.
Absolutely. And one of the second thing that we're going to talk about here, and I'm just going to read a scripture that is going to take us right there, and it comes from Romans 12:12, which says that rejoice in hope, be patient in suffering, persevere in prayer. And this scripture in particular really tells us that our God is a promise keeper.
Yes, he is.
Our God will always
fulfill his promise.
Fulfill it. He will always stand up for you.
Yeah.
You know. And I just love how this scripture tells us that, you know, be patient in suffering. You know, are you going through a season where, you know, somebody's sick, or you may be in S6 VAC or S4 VAC or even P7 VAC, and you're waiting for your exam results to come out.
Yeah.
Trust the fact that you read and believe God to do the rest. Mm-hmm. You know, just release everything for God to take over. Be joyful.
Yeah.
Rejoice in the season that you are in right now, and have hope in Jesus. Mm-hmm. Have hope that he is going to be there, and whatever he has said over your life is going to come to fulfillment.
Mm.
That he says that he has a plan for you.
Yes, he does.
You know, he knows each and every detail about your life. You need to believe and trust in what his word has said over you.
Yeah.
And that has to be a standard. That has to be you.
The way that we live, yeah. Yeah, I agree with you. And so that's a proper second response that we ought to have, rejoicing. And the second part of that scripture talks about the fact that we ought to remain in prayer, even while we wait, to be people that stick it in, even while we wait. Remaining in the presence of God in prayer, even while we wait. As we start to land the plane, what have we learned today? If God fulfilled his promise to an individual, to a people, he can keep and he will keep his word to you. My challenge for you this week and for the rest of your life, really, is to get familiar with the promises of God that are found in his word. Read the word of God, my friend. Get familiar with his promises over your health, over your finances, over your future, over your purpose, over what and who he has called you to be. That way, when the storms come your way, you can hang on to them. You can hold tight onto the promises that God has made to you, and you'll be found immovable in him. Yeah. Because the only variable is us. God is constant. He will never change his mind. The Bible says this: God is not a man that he should change his mind. This is what this Bible says. For let me just find this scripture here. This is a scripture that I want to read with you as we start to land the plane. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 20. This is what the Bible says. For no matter how many promises God has made, they are yes in Christ. And so through him, the amen is spoken by us. And so you ought to hang on to every single promise that is made. And so by ripple effect, you ought to know every single one of those promises. As we land the plane, there's this story that is told of this gentleman that was wandering by a cliff. And so somehow he slipped, you know, and fell, you know, over the cliff. Yeah. And as he was trying to fight, try and get a grip or get a hold of something, he held onto a branch. And as holding onto that branch, he called out and shouted, "Anybody there? I need some help," obviously, like anybody that would be falling. And so, and this is really just an example. And so this voice speaks out from heaven and says, "I'm here." And this was God. And the person says, "Okay, so what should I do next?" And this voice and God tells him, "Let go of the branch." You know, and that's just that is just, you know, against everything I was waiting for. Why? Because I mean, I let go of the branch, then what should I do? And that talks a lot about our very first response, which I spoke about, one of trust. But today, even as we talk about God being one that keeps his promises, I want you not to waver in doubt, to be anchored, to be always trusting that if God said it, he's gonna do it. And as we land the plane, I want to ask you a question, my friend. Even as we are talking about the promise keeper, you could be right now wondering about, you know, the fate of your life or the fate of your future. Or what will I become? Will what I dreamt of come to pass? There's one whom you can put your trust in and not have to worry about any of that. And be assured about your time in eternity. He's going to keep his promise about saving you. If you do not know him, I want to lead you in this short and small prayer. And it's going to allow you, or really just enable you, to put your faith in Jesus. I want you to repeat every single word from the bottom of your heart as you give your life to Jesus. Are you ready? Let's pray together. Just repeat these words after me and say, "Dear Jesus, today I've heard your word. I've heard that you're a promise keeper. And today I open my heart. I want every single one of your promises to come to pass in my life. So I give you my life. I make you my Lord and my Savior. From today on, I'm going to live for you. I choose you. In Jesus' name, amen, 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 amen." If you've said that prayer for your first time, boy, I'm very, very glad. I'm very excited. I'm glad that you have chosen to put your trust and to give your life to Jesus. Why don't you get in touch with us? Send us an email, moft.connect@watotochurch.com. There's a team of people that would love to celebrate with you, but also to come alongside you on this new beautiful journey.
Absolutely. And Christmas is around the corner. What does this mean right here in Watoto? Christmas cantata is back. You know, all the way from 19th all the way to 23rd December. 6 p.m., 8 p.m. You don't want to miss a show. Bring your family, bring your friends. Come and have a good time. Come and enjoy this experience, because it's going to be awesome.
It will be absolutely amazing. This last one is going out to you, world changers. Morph Camp is back. You ought to know by now. I want you to do is really just make sure that you book your ticket. 180,000 shillings. You can pass by the youth hub at Watoto Church downtown and book your ticket, or visit any of our social media platforms. platforms to make sure you let us know that you want to be a part of this camp. Our theme is Amarap, absolutely amazing. Don't miss this camp for nothing on earth. Guys, it's been great having you today with us. Until next Sunday, we want to say bye-bye. Don't forget to follow us on all our social media platforms, and that is
it.
That is it. Bye-bye. See you guys. Thank you.